I love the old shape of vise that came with my mill, but recently I got a great deal on a used Vertex CNC vise, which is better and will let me use the shaper vise on the shaper. The Vertex vise was very scruffy when I got it. To get it mounted, I found that I could use the hold downs that I made for Toolfest a couple of years ago. The problem is, those hold downs need some custom M10 T-nuts to be made. This material should do. It's a bit rusty though. I need enough length to make up 6 T-nuts, 3 a side. To save my cutters on the mill, I'll brush off as much rust as I can. I'm debarking it using a 2-flute indexable carbide end mill. Basically, this is a small diameter face mill. When I'm debarking something this rusty, I want to make sure I'm using carbide and going gently, getting underneath the rust with a good sized cut, but a slow to moderate feed rate. When it comes to a finished cut, I'm speeding up the spindle, slowing down the feed, and I'm using a thick cutting oil to try and get as reasonable surface as possible from this mild steel. Deburring in between cuts just to minimise any chance of the workpiece cockling over in the vise. I learned that word cockling from Mr. Crispin, thanks for that. You can see me already using the mill vise here. I've used 2 quite undersized T-nuts for this, so I'm going very carefully with the milling. I could have used the shaper vise, but I was really keen to try this new one out. New T-nuts is definitely the first job just to make this thing safer to use. The rest of this milling is just bringing the stock down to a size, and then I also milled 2 rebates to a size, but I seem to have lost the footage of that. I got close in both dimensions on both sides of the workpiece, and then did a final cleanup cut that brought the shoulder and the cheek to size in one go. Then I flipped the workpiece around without moving the spindle or the table, and I got a good symmetry. I don't use layout die very much. I prefer to rely on the DRO and on direct measurements of the part. I suppose most of the time I'm making simple stuff which doesn't need a lot of layout, but for this job layout die is ideal, because I'll go from drilling in the mill to bandsawing, then back to the mill for cleaning up the ends of each T-nut. The layout die gives me a reference which persists between machines, and it works even when I've chopped off my reference surface. By the way, I did clean up one end off camera before laying these lines out. There's nothing spectacular about the drilling and tapping. I start with edge finding. Move on to spot drilling. I believe this is a drill I've sharpened on the D-bit grinder and it works well. I do like to cheat and use a combination of metric and imperial drills. I go through with my closest metric drill, 8.5mm in this case, but 11.32 is much closer to the M10 tap drill size, so I use that to finish. These zero flute countersink bits make a really nice job of countersinking without any chatter, and I'm a big fan. With the tapping itself, you can see I'm just driving the tap into the work under power, which starts it off nice and square, then it slips in the chuck, and I take over with a tap wrench. These 6 M10 holes took only a few minutes to do. I also countersink the other side of the holes off camera by lifting up the work to the countersink bit just for speed. I did most of the bandsawing using the bandsaw vise, but the last bit was a bit too small to hold, so I'm cutting between the 3mm tram lines here by hand so that I have a clean-up line to work to after. Now I'm working to those clean-up lines. It's good to look after the vise by putting a piece in each side to stop it racking. This should give you a better grip on the part too. I'm making sure I deburr any freshly milled edges so that it doesn't interfere with proper clamping. I do like this part. The finished part comes to life when it's deburred and it feels nice in the hand. I sandblasted these off camera. I figure if I can't see what I'm doing, you probably can't either. And a quick dose of chemical blue and they are ready for service. Here they are, holding the newly cleaned up vise in place, freshly trammed and ready for years of service. Thanks for watching.